Yes, sir.
It is visible. It's a Python programming language, Van Rossum, and it is in
Yes, sir.
Google.
Yes, sir. It is
It's
visible.
visible. Thank you very much.
It's visible, sir. Thank
Thank
you,
you.
sir.
Anytime you can raise the questions and all these things. Thank you. Okay, so quickly I'm going to this. This is all these things. Let's see what the next thing we can do. Yeah. So these are the main thing we are much interested in our assignments. Other than Sarah said, the Python is a very powerful feature in NumPy when you can handle large number of large means large. That means maybe gigabyte storage, like megabyte storage. By NumPy, this is a separate module. Generally, you have to include it. Import NumPy as NP. Import NumPy as an NP, the standard command. You can make it import NumPy as NK also, but it is never. It is an unwritten law in Python programming. They always mention the same symbol. Import NumPy as NP. This is a plotlib. Matplotlib is a famous. You can any graphs and all these things you can do. This is NLTK, one module. It is for natural language processing. You can develop a small tool for any game and all these things. Pygame is also, you can generate Pygame. Django is one framework. There is another framework called Flask. That is very useful for any applications which can run on your web app, which can run your own Android app or iOS app. That is great. And there is even GUI. We'll cover it. We'll try to cover at least two, three of it. Can please any question you can address it. This is already covered. This is the one of the main things of Python. Don't think this is a Python has copied it from Java. Please every time you alert me whether the screen is visible. I am showing the Python virtual machine screen. Yeah, please. I cannot see the text window. It is visible. Anyone? Please?
Yes.
Thank you very
yes,
much.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. So this is a same concept as a Java. Dot java file or dot py file, and this is a bytecode. After you after Python you make a bytecode and it is run on Python virtual machine. Then you might ask why don't for Java, but Java has some issues with Oracle, because Java, whenever it was developed by Sun, that was in free. Right now Java people are hesitating to do much development work in Java, because Java is now Oracle property, and Oracle is not that way traditional with the open source movement. So that is one. And the Python is, whenever it is declared by a single person like Stroustrup, it is not any particular company's language, and they have already declared the Python will be always free. So that is the reason the people are going for Python. Even Python is the favorite choice of development from Microsoft and also Google. That's it. So that is the reason Python is popular, but that is not the end of the road. But why is a virtual machine? I have covered it, because virtual machine gives you lots of advantage, isolation from actual hardware. So you have several kinds of hardware, maybe Intel 8086 bus architecture, you can maybe strong upgrade architecture, you can be Apple PC type of architecture, you can make any different architecture machine. You can learn your computer science architecture classes, but it creates a virtual machine out of it, and the code will run on it. So advantage of it, that it will, disadvantage it will be slower, but advantage it, you can make it online, you can transfer it to another machine. So it is almost unshutdownable. That is, it is almost, exception will be less. Your performance will be elastic. So if you need more customers in the application, you can make it deploy in more powerful machine. So that is the advantage of virtual machine, and virtual machine handling is much better. So you can also load several virtual machine on your Windows laptop or Linux laptop to VMware. So virtual machine is slower, but virtual machine is sometimes is very good for work. Yeah, any question on virtual machine? Yeah, then this is how the Python runs. This is a Python versus Java, same thing. Here Python and almost they are same. But Python is free, I am told you. And Python has more data structure utilities, like you can have list also, you can have the tuple also. The difference between list and tuple, I'll just come to this. Yeah, this is, I expect if you can develop a Python based web app as your assignment, you can start. I think I expecting it very much after 1 month. You should be able to write a web app to Python. There you have to do it a little bit. It is Android. You can create a Python app on your Android phone also. Then you have to learn the Kotlin. Is a good development block so that you can develop any web app and also which can run on Android also. This is a covered. We have covered. This is area is the slide is visible, please? Is the slide is visible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Good. Thank you very much. So this one I want to highlight. This is a particular if then else condition in Java, and this is in Python. See, you have unnecessary brackets. Brackets are not human readable first. So it is friendly for machine, but Python code is like this. It is only 4 lines, and you see there is no unnecessary brackets. So Python is more readable, I think. But though it is looks like it is more readable, but number of lines are less. Day by day it will be clearer. So Python maybe is much more readable. Let's see the next. Yeah. See here I want to, let's see this one, yeah, this one, yeah, it is, see, you just want to print a hello world. See this one, this Python, this one I have already told, it would not work. It is a statement I covered from Python 2, okay, so this is, this will not work, this will work. So if in Python 3, you have to have all print, you have to be some within quote. Earlier version is Python 2, but it is a single statement. If you see it from here in C++, you see you have to have include this amount of code, include iostream.h, int main and all this. In Java, you have to declare a class, you have to hello world, and you have to say public, static, void, main. So it's sometimes very difficult to be understood and to make clear, but if you want to just press hello world, it is much easier to print hello world. Have you appreciated this? I think I believe it really has to be appreciated. So it is by single command you can do this, which is not there. Any question, please? Okay, so this is how to declare in Python. See here, a Java, you have to have a class declaration. Python, it doesn't require. But how to create function? So in Java, you cannot create a function without a class. But Python, you can do it like C. So that way, Python is somewhat similar to C also. But you can declare a Python function under a class. And how to create a function with a def is a keyword. And the function name and this, and there is, you can use the documentation of the Python function with a docstring command, three triple quotes I have mentioned earlier, but that code will be the part of the Python PYC file, and this is a simple Python file, and this is a Java file. Yes, this, all these things should be given to you, don't worry. I'll Is the screen is visible? Screen is visible, please.
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much. Okay, so Java. This is Python. Again and again, I am telling you, it is a dynamic typing. That means your variable A can be sometimes integer, sometimes float, but you cannot change it. Once it is integer, you cannot change it on the fly. That 3 can be changed to 3.0. You have to casting it. So that is called dynamic typing, but strong entity. Am I clear? What is dynamic typing? What is static typing? Static typing means like C, Java, you have to declare the variable beforehand, that what kind of variable it is coming, if it's integer, float, and that is, I also find that is also very good. It's a good discipline to program with, but Python, I personally do not like about this dynamic typing, but what is to be done. It is there in the Python. That is one strong forte of the Python, that is a dynamic typing, so that the variable you don't have to declare earlier. So sometimes the error might creep in. Your maybe variable name you have mistype, the new variable will be created. That is the reason the earlier basic also that concept is there. You don't have to declare variable. When that time Bill Gates has developed operating system through BASIC, at that time you don't have to declare the variable name earlier. But the same concept comes here in the Python itself, that it is a variable, you don't have to name it earlier, it can be anything. And variable is but once you declare the variable, if you want to convert it, you have to have used the casting method, that is called dynamic typing or strong entity type. Am I clear? What is dynamic typing and strong entity? Your C Java is static typing strong entity, and your Python is dynamic typing strong entity, and another language is Perl, that is dynamic typing weak entity, so that you can convert it with the casting. So your 12 is sometimes means 10 plus 2, or your 12 sometimes means string 12. It is a Perl, but in Python that is not. It is a dynamic typing and strong entity. Am I clear? Please ask a question or anything. Have you said yes or no? Just say yes. Have you understood? Hello? Is my string visible? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Have you understood this is?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yeah, understood.
Okay, okay. Thank you very much. So, these are the structure type. This in Python, there are lots of support. Like you can see a list of integers. List is more powerful than array in C. And list can built in, list can contain a list, same as array, but one the power of the list is you can have a multiple types of objects, maybe integer, maybe floating point. And there is another concept, yeah, the list can be defined like this, list can contain a list, okay, so that's it. But there is another competitor of list that is called tuple. The list is modifiable, tuple is not modifiable. So where the tuple will be used generally key dictionary in key elements, that is called tuple. There is another competitive ways is a set. Set cannot have any duplicate items. There is unordered collection, and the tuple is an ordered collection. You can index it with 0, 1, 2, 3 like list, but tuple you cannot change, add or item. Set you can add and modify item, but it cannot have a duplicate entry. It doesn't have an index in set. 0, 1 like this, and there is another concept called frozen set. Frozen set means you cannot add and remove. So all these are powerful data structures are built in with Python. So you can, your problem can be lesser code. You don't, because all these are available to you. Another is powerful dictionary is powerful is a dictionary. Yeah, any concept confusion? This is, you already know, I have covered, Sarah has covered. This is interesting thing about list and tuple. Is the screen visible, please? Hello?
It is visible, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Okay, so this is when to use list and when to use tuple. List is when there is any addition and modification, and tuple is whenever it is no addition and modification. Like if you say like string, maybe my your name, your father's name, your mother's name, you can put in a tuple, that it is not modifiable. So that is, I think, a better example of a tuple. Date of birth, so all this you can put a your personal information like your passport number, your Aadhaar number. It cannot be, it better to put a tuple, or maybe it's a frozen set. Another better concept is a frozen set. So it cannot be changed, there should not be duplicate items. Yes. So you have to think about the real life and whether you put into a list, whether you put into tuple, so then your program would be better. Yes. Any question, please?
Sir?
Yeah, please, questions. What's your name?
Sir. Yes.
Yeah.
Sumon.
Okay. Okay.
Sir,
please.
Among list and tuple, which is faster, sir?
Which one? Which? What is the question? Good question. Tell me.
Sir, list and tuple, which is faster?
Definitely tuple. because tuple is always a faster, because it and least will be always slower, but the tuple will be stored in a place where there will be contiguous memory, and least is stored in a place which may not be contiguous memory, because least is a dynamic, least you can add an item, so least will be always slower and tuple will be always faster. Good question. Any other question? Yeah, this is good question. Yeah, set and dictionary, any question? This is how to create string. You can create string by double quote and single quote. I prefer with double quote. List is this way. You can create an empty list with this. The first one is create empty list. Is the screen visible? Hello, is the screen visible, please?
Yes,
thank you. Because I am always worried whether the screen is visible or not. Okay, so this is a list one. This is a you can create an empty list like this, and you can create a list, but this is a modifiable. And tuple, you can create an empty tuple like this. So by the first bracket and first bracket end, it's a tuple. This is a list, and you can create a tuple like this also, like tuple 2 equal to 5 comma, but I prefer not to. But if it is a 5, then it will not be tuple, then it is a typical integer. But how to distinguish between tuple and integer? Say it is a comma is there in tuple 2, but it is a bit confusing. Another better term is like initialize tuple like this. This is an empty tuple, this is a tuple with a single element, okay, and this is it. Okay, so what is the difference between tuple and list? You please read it and ask me question. Ask question. I am waiting. And otherwise say no question. So you have to answer anyway, either a question or no question. Please make your microphone on and ask a question. Otherwise is okay. Winnie is there? I think Winnie is not there. Who else? Ask a question. Is it visible? Screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, please. Any question there? Any question there? Okay. Then these are the difference between list and tuple. A list can consist mutable objects. Objects mutable, you can change it. Creating a list is slower. A list is data stored in brackets is, and tuple is a first bracket. This is the tuple has a small memory. Tuple is faster. Tuple is used as a key element in a dictionary. Okay. Is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
It's visible, sir.
Okay. Question? You understood. So we have covered almost. This is a tuple. This is one good thing. I think C also have it. You can have a reverse index. So like here tuple can be sequenced, unlike set. Set cannot have any sequence number. Here 0, 1, 2, 3, and here you can say minus 7 this one. Okay. So this is, you can access an element of a list or tuple, but not set and frozen set by the index. So you can have a forward index, is a reverse index. Screen visible? Screen visible or not? Please? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. So
yes,
this is,
yes, sir. It will be visible.
Thank you, thank you. So this is the tuple, advantage of using tuples over list. Somebody asks a question. I think you should get the answer from here. Any question? So you can always convert to tuple to list by these functions.
Sir, it is mentioned that tuples are safe. How to safe?
Tuples are safe means, yes, good question. Tuples, because they're immutable, so because any program is developed by one or two more than programmers, so in accidentally, if you want something to be not modifiable, like I have mentioned, maybe your name, your father's name, your mother's name, your date of birth, you can put in a list, but I think it is preferred, you should, something unchangeable thing, you should put in a tuple. So that way tuple are safe. So which things which cannot be modified, you want to put in a list, then it should be a, that structure. If you, in C you can put in a structure, but structure anything you can change. So if a structure in C like thing structure, you don't want structure, you have many type of elements, say integer, character, float. If you say a particular structure like your personal details, you don't want to be changed, I think it should be better in tuple or maybe a frozen set. Am I clear? In which case,
okay. Thank
when you. Do these tuples are safe? Good question. Okay. Any question more? Should I change slide? You say yes or no? Taking your feedback, because I can't see you, because text box is not a chat box is not available. Yeah, this is a group side, so you can see when to see. This is a list with a third bracket. This is a tuple, and this is a dictionary. Dictionary is comma separated, and left hand side a key element. A key element can be always immutable. It can be, it cannot be list. It can be tuple. It can be frozen set. It can be a single item. Right hand side can be anything. Okay. And it can be also a dictionary within a dictionary is also possible, like list a content dictionary. So dictionary within dictionary is also possible. This is a single level dictionary. Any question? Then you can ask me what should be a dictionary. What is your answer? May I ask a question? When you put a dictionary? Yes. Yes. Any answer? Where I put dictionary? Any, are you, the slide is visible? This slide is visible or not? Hello?
It's visible, sir.
Yeah, so good. So tell me, give me example in your practical life when I use dictionary. Say I want a, I have a first year, new first year is coming. So their roll numbers are there. Their roll numbers, first they don't get the roll numbers, the internal roll numbers are there. Their number, their name may not be right now. I am hearing that there may not be case sensitive. There'd be maybe first one S and T generally comes to section B. Maybe they are, some are section A and some B, section B. How to get their phone numbers and all? I can put them in a dictionary. If somebody is named Shubham, Shubham Upadhyay, say somebody. So I can make it Shubham Upadhyay. I make a hash value generate to it and store a phone number. So I don't have to sort the all the names by ascending order or descending order. I just make a hash value with your name, and with that hash value on the left hand side and right hand side, your phone number, your email and all these things, then the I can search your phone number, your personal details with bigger one because of the hashing advantage. But what is the cost of it? Hashing function is the cost of it. Whenever I am storing a new item, I have to hash that. But that is time I, whenever I'm adding and deleting, I have to hash only. But at the real time, I get the performance O1. But if I put it in ascending order or descending order, then I have to do it binary search. Okay, so binary search, what is this? I have to first it whole items to be in ascending order. So that is a cost involved. And then I go for binary search. I go to the middle of the item. Then again, if it's it is a less, then I go again left hand portion. If it is on right, in the right hand portion, again go. So binary search will give me the log n time. Is there an n time? In the n items, the searching will be log n. What are the restriction of the binary search is? Your items should be in sorted on a way. So sorting a cost, sometimes the sorting cost n square, O n square or O n log n. And then even if it is sorted, your name, then getting, finding out it would be log n. But if you put your name, phone number and everything in a hashed manner, so only hashing I require time. And I don't have to put it in ascending and descending order, and I can get it O1. So you definitely see this is a pretty advantage, and Python does give it support. So your program will run faster, and it can be developed more quickly. So have you understood? It is visible, and have you understood my example? Yes. 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 Hello.
Yes,
sir. Yeah, I think we have gone, Lord Beatles. You should relax because it's evening time. So any questions? So what I have discussed today, what Sir has discussed. So we try to have the experience the data structure. Next day, I try to cover all this and my earlier videos also. Please see and you can. This is now open. You can make your microphone on and video on. So I am closing the lecture and not. I am taking another 2-3 minutes, take the questions and please don't go.